Hi, welcome back to the Doctors of Medicine channel. Today we'll be looking at the histology of the GIT. Right, as you know, the GIT runs from the oral cavity down to the anus, but we will not look at the histology of the oral cavity today, neither will we look at the histology of the rectum and anal canal, because we'll actually cover that in pelvic histology. But we'll look at the general histology of the GIT, the histology of the esophagus, the histology of the stomach, and the histology of the intestines. Okay, so generally, the GIT is organized into four distinct layers, right, histologically. We have the innermost layer, which is in contact with the lumen, which we call the mucosa. The mucosa is made up of the epithelium, the lamina propria, and the muscularis mucosa. Okay? We have the submucosa. Submucosa, this is mainly connective tissue. All right. We have the muscularis externa. This is mainly smooth muscle, but however, it varies as to where we're actually looking at. For example, in the esophagus, the upper two-thirds of the esophagus, we have some fibers which are actually striated. Okay, and then in the rest of the GIT, we have smooth muscle. In the anal canal, it becomes again the external anal sphincter becomes striated. So it varies as to where we're actually looking at. Then we have the outermost layer, or sort of like a covering. We have serosa. Serosa, this is connective tissue, loose connective tissue covered with a layer of mesothelium, or this is just simple squamous epithelium. Okay, and then we have adventitia. Adventitia is just connective tissue. All right, we'll look in depth later. All right, so first of all, the mucosa. The mucosa is made up of the epithelium, right, lamina propria, and the muscularis mucosa. So for the epithelium, it varies again as to where we are actually looking at. For example, in the esophagus, the epithelium is stratified squamous. From the stomach, the intestines, the epithelium is simple columnar. All right, so it varies as to where we are looking at, depending on the function. Primarily, in the esophagus, we mainly need the protective function. That's why we find stratified squamous epithelium there. It's stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. Right. And then in the intestines, we need absorption. Right. So we need fast uptake and rapid movement of things through the layer, the epithelial layer. That's why you find simple columnar epithelium in the intestines. Okay, right. For the lamina propria, this is simply loose connective tissue, which is well vascularized with blood vessels, lymph vessels. All right, that's where you also find our diffuse lymphatic tissue. We can sometimes find glands in the lamina propria. Okay, for example, most of the glands from the stomach, the intestines, they are found in the lamina propria, most of them, right? And also, the lamina propria, this one, it can fold. We'll actually see that when you look at different sections, right? Then we have the muscularis mucosa. Muscularis mucosa, it's arranged as an inner circular layer and outer longitudinal layer of smooth muscle. Muscularis mucosa is always smooth muscle, and some of these fibers actually project into the lamina propria. This we can see it in the villi of the intestines. These muscular fibers which project into the lamina propria will help with secretions, and also we help with localized movement of the villi. All right. Right, now let's look at the submucosa. The submucosa is composed of dense irregular connective tissue. Okay, right, so this one again, it contains the usual elements of connective tissue, right? And then it also houses blood and lymph vessels. Okay, and then we can also find glands in the submucosa. For example, the duodenal glands or the Brunner's glands, they form the submucosa, and the esophageal glands proper and the submucosa. Okay. Then another special element which you find in the submucosa here is the nerve plexus, which you actually call Meissner's plexus. This one is secretomotor functions to the glands in the submucosa. Okay. Right. So that's basically all about the submucosa. Now let's look at the muscularis externa. The muscularis externa, this can be smooth muscle, it can be striated muscle depending on the location. So the upper third of the esophagus, the muscularis externa, is purely striated muscle. Okay. The middle third of the esophagus, it gets to be mixed smooth muscle and striated, right? But for the rest of the GIT up until the anus, it's actually smooth muscle. Okay. So the muscularis externa is organized into two layers. Basically, we have the inner circular layer with the outer longitudinal layer, right? But however, in the stomach you find a third layer, the innermost layer, which is an oblique oriented layer. All right, so between the two layers of the muscularis externa, we actually find a nerve plexus there, which we call Oberg plexus or the myenteric plexus. This one innervates the muscularis externa, which will bring about the peristaltic motions of the GIT. Okay. As for the serosa or adventitia, remember we said serosa, this is connective tissue with mesothelium. Okay, adventitia is just connective tissue. So serosa, we will find it where we do not have attachment of the GIT to the external body wall. Okay, so we find it in intraperitoneal organs. This is actually peritoneum, visceral peritoneum, when you go to cross anatomy. Okay. Adventitia is more of connective tissue, right? So this is connective tissue which will blend in with the connective tissue of the body wall, so that we can actually fix structures or organs to the posterior abdominal wall. That's where we find adventitia in retroperitoneal organs. Okay. Right. Then we also have important structures in the GIT which we call sphincters. These regulate the movement of contents of the GIT. Right. So for example, we have the pharyngeal esophageal sphincter. This one is the sphincter at the boundary of the pharynx and the esophagus, right? This one is formed by the lower part of the cricopharyngeal muscle. So this one is actually made up of the muscularis externa is made up of striated muscle, okay, which is somatic nerve supply. But however, its main function is to prevent the entry of air into the esophagus. Okay. Right. Then secondly, we have the inferior or the lower esophageal sphincter. This is located at the gastroesophageal junction. Okay, this one is not an anatomical sphincter. No. It's more of a physiological sphincter, which is maintained by pressure differences between the terminal portion of the esophagus, the sphincter itself, and the cardia of the stomach. So the pressure difference aided by or reinforced by the crural fibers of the diaphragm will make up the sphincter. Okay. Right. We also have the pyloric sphincter. This is one is between the pylorus of the stomach and the duodenum. So it's at the pyloro-duodenal junction. This way of the pyloric sphincter, which is made up of a thickening of the circular layer of smooth muscle of the muscularis externa, right? This one now it controls gastric emptying, so as to prevent the passage of acidic gastric contents into the duodenum. Okay, so it sort of like prevents the occurrence of what you call duodenal ulcers, which are caused by the passage of acid into the duodenum. Okay, we have the ileocecal valve. This one is located at the terminal junction, at the junction of the ileum and the cecum, and then also the internal anal sphincter. Right. So basically, these are the sphincters we have. Their function is to regulate movement of contents of the GI tube. All right. So this is the general outline or the general structure of the GIT. All right. So you can see here internally we have the mucosa. All right, which is made up of the epithelium here, which is made up of the lamina propria and the muscularis mucosa. Okay. Then, underneath the mucosa, so this one, this innermost layer, this one, this here, is our mucosa. All right. Then, just after the mucosa, we find our submucosa. This one, you can see the red dots here, and they are pertaining to blood vessels, right? Also find lymph vessels in there. Also find capillaries, and the capillaries which we find in the innermost layers of the GIT are actually fenestrated type, the fenestrated type of capillaries. Okay, so this one now is our circularly oriented layer of the muscularis externa, and then this one here is the longitudinal oriented layer of the muscularis externa. Right, then externally now, that's where we find our serosa or adventitia, depending on where, on whether this organ or that part of the GIT is intraperitoneal or retroperitoneal. So remember, when it is intraperitoneal, we have serosa. Okay, and when it is retroperitoneal, we have adventitia. All right, so you can see here blood vessels and lymph vessels passing through the mesenteries or the peritoneum. All right, and then they will form further smaller branches which will go to the connective tissue in the submucosa. All right, also the connective tissue in the lamina propria. Okay, so basically this is the general structure of the GIT. Okay, again, this one is the histologic section of the GIT. You can see here, this is our mucosa, made up of stratified squamous epithelium. All right, then underneath the stratified squamous epithelium, we'll actually find our lamina propria. Okay, which contains blood vessels here, diffuse lymphatic tissue, lymph vessels. Right here, we can see a lymphatic nodule in the lamina propria. So take note of this. Lymphatic nodules can be found within the lamina propria. They can be also found within the submucosa. Okay. Right, underneath the lamina propria, we got our muscularis mucosa here. Okay, and then this now is the submucosa. Okay, it's now the submucosa. You can see glands here in the submucosa. Okay, we can see ducts here, excretory ducts, which will open into the lumen of the GIT. Okay, you can see these are blood vessels as well. All right, then this one now is the circular layer of the muscularis externa, the inner layer. All right, then this one is the outer longitudinal layer. So between these two layers, we find a thin band of connective tissue which will house the myenteric plexus, the small blood the blood vessels which will supply this muscle. Okay, the lymphatics which will also supply this muscle. All right, then externally, we find either adventitia or serosa, depending on where the section has been taken. Okay.